The ancient people discovered that long, slender pieces of certain ores, when free to rotate, always align themselves in the same direction. One end points north, the other one to south. These objects were first found in part of ancient Greece, Magnesia, which also gave them their name, Magnetis, meaning stone from Magnesia. A magnet is an object with a pair of opposite poles, called north and south poles. They point towards the Earth's magnetic poles, so that sailors and navigators rely on them to determine their directions. A magnet so used is called a compass. The end of a magnet that points north is referred to as the North Pole or N Pole. And the end that points due south is the South Pole or S Pole of the magnet. When two or more magnets are brought together, they exert forces on each other. Like poles repel each other. For example, on this figure we have two north poles coming together, so these two magnets will repel each other. In the second figure, we have two S poles, two south poles coming together. It means these two magnets also will repel each other. On the third figure, we have two opposite poles, north pole and south pole. Unlike poles, they attract each other, so these two magnets will move towards each other. Breaking a magnet into pieces does not isolate the poles from each other, which means you can't get a magnet with only one pole. Instead, all the pieces become magnets, each with its own two poles. Objects that are magnets always have both poles. You can't get single pole. Single poles do not exist. Hitting a magnet weakens its magnetism, and at some point magnet loses its property, but cooling does not ordinarily strengthen it. When one charged particle approaches the other one, due to electric fields around them, there will be either attractive or repulsive force between them. Or, if an object enters a gravitational field of the Earth, it will be attracted towards the planet. Similarly, if any magnetic substance will be held close to another magnetic substance, they will attract or repel each other. This happens because of magnetic field around them. Magnetic field is a region in space around the magnetic substance in which another magnetic substance will experience a force. Magnetic fields are vector quantities with magnitude and direction. We are using magnetic field lines to show the strength and direction of magnetic field. One method to observe these lines is spreading fine iron filings or dust on a piece of paper which is laid on top of a magnet. Another method is placing compass around the magnet. Compass needles will point in the direction of local magnetic field, towards a magnet's south pole and away from its north pole. There are some rules while drawing magnetic field lines. Magnetic field lines are closed lines which leave the magnet from north pole and enter the magnet from the south pole. Inside the magnet, they are directed from south pole towards the north pole. We can see these two rules clearly on the first image. As you can see, on the image, none of these lines cross each other. And finally, the closer magnetic field lines to each other, the stronger magnetic field is. In the second figure, the strongest magnetic field is in the section between two magnets. But the same region has the weakest magnetic field in the last image. Magnetic field lines created by two like poles repel each other in this figure by resulting weaker magnetic field. Earth is also acting as a giant magnet. It has its own magnetic poles, and these poles are different than the ones we study in geography class. We know that unlike poles are attracting each other. So, north needle of a compass is directed towards the magnetic south pole, which is close but not at the same position with geographical north pole. Similarly, magnetic north pole of the Earth is close to geographical south pole. Geographical poles of the Earth are fixed, but magnetic poles are continuously changing their positions. They move few kilometers a year and completely swap places after a while. Earth, being a magnet, has magnetic field around it which protects it from furious electromagnetic storms generated by the sun. Charged particles from the sun travel into the magnetic field of the Earth, which directs them to the poles, crashing into atoms and molecules in the atmosphere. This releases energy in the form of light. We know these lights as aurora australis. The Earth's magnetic field actually traps these particles, and they are blown towards the upper atmosphere by the solar wind. This could damage telecommunications on Earth. Some animals, like African elephant, monarch butterflies, pigeons, and so on, can generate and detect magnetic fields, which helps them to find their way. On the right-hand image, you can see the roots of some of these animals.
A compass needle that points to the north, and the mysterious polar lights. Both have the same cause, the Earth's magnetic field. Our Earth is a gigantic magnet. Its core is a huge sphere made of rotating nickel and iron. The rotation produces electricity, and wherever electric current is flowing, there also is an invisible magnetic field. The geomagnetic field covers the whole Earth and goes a few thousand kilometers into space. It is our protective shield, acting like an umbrella to keep away the harmful particles coming from outer space and the sun. When they hit the magnetic field, they may start to glow. These green glowing particles are the polar lights you can see in the sky around the poles. Like all magnets, our Earth has two magnetic poles where the magnetic force is the strongest. But do not confuse the magnetic poles with the geographical poles. These are the ends of the Earth's rotational axis in the north and in the south. The geographical poles are fixed, but the magnetic poles change their position over time. In fact, they move at the rate of several kilometers per year. The reason? The geomagnetic field that the Earth's rotating metal core produces is not entirely stable. But for centuries, the geomagnetic field and the magnetic compass needle have helped sailors and explorers find the right direction. The compass tip always points to the Earth's magnetic north.
The magnetic properties of many materials are explained in terms of a model in which an electron is said to spin on its axis. The spinning electron represents a charge that is in motion, and moving charges create magnetic fields. In atoms containing many electrons, the electrons usually pair up with their spins in different directions, causing their fields to cancel each other. For this reason, most substances such as wood and plastic are not magnetic. However, in materials such as iron, cobalt, and nickel, the magnetic fields produced by the electron spins do not cancel each other completely. Such materials are said to be ferromagnetic. In ferromagnetic materials, strong coupling occurs between neighboring atoms to form large groups of atoms whose net spins are aligned. These groups are called domains, and domains typically range in size from about 10 power to negative 4 cm to 10 power to negative 1 cm. In an unmagnetized substance, the domains are randomly oriented like in the given figure. When an external magnetic field is applied, the orientation of the magnetic fields of each domain may change slightly to more closely align with the external magnetic field. This alignment enhances the applied magnetic field. Magnetic domain is a region composed of a group of atoms whose magnetic fields are aligned in the same direction.